Low Carb Burger, it's all about the meat.
Remember the anti-carb craze?
9 great-tasting low-carb dishes.
Well, after a few years of low-carb everything,
vodka zero-carb martini,
the pendulum has swung back. Thanks to new research that shows that whole grains can lower the risk of heart disease and some cancer, good carbs or whole grains are back in style.
Whole grain health is sweeping America.
Literally hundreds of products touting whole grain goodness are popping up on supermarket shelves. Everything from whole grain Chips Ahoy to whole grain Goldfish, even whole grain white bread. Just last week, the Food and Drug Administration issued preliminary guidelines on whole grain food labels. But nothing's changed on your grocery shelves. Things are just as confusing as ever.
Pop quiz, definition, what's a whole grain?
I have no idea.
Whole grains never got much attention until the government flipped the food pyramid on its head last year.
The USDA has changed the food pyramid, and it recommends more whole grains in your diet.
I guess we need to eat more whole grains.
Let's be honest. Most of us don't even know what whole grains means. Here are some examples. Whole wheat flour, oatmeal, brown rice. But for a processed food to claim whole grains, it has to include every part of the grain, which is harder to manufacture and harder to keep fresh on the shelves. But experts say watch out. Not every product that appears to have whole grain nutrition is what it's cracked up to be.
All the products that say they contain whole grain do, but they contain just widely varying amounts of whole grain, and the overall nutritional profile of these products ranges from, you know, from good to bad to ugly.
Dr. David Katz, a nutrition professor at Yale University and an ABC News medical consultant, says one way consumers may get confused is by focusing on healthy-sounding words like oat nut, cracked wheat, or 12 grain. But watch out. Those are usually not whole grain products.
We start right here. We've got a 7-grain and a 12-grain bread.
You know, that sounds like a lot of grain.
Well, it does, and 7 sounds good, but 12 sounds even better.
So how do you know if you're getting whole grains? Dr. Katz showed us his formula for decoding the complicated labels. Because fiber provides much of the health benefits of whole grains, he says a serving should contain at least 2 grams of fiber per 100 calories.
But oddly, there's more fiber in that 7-grain bread. This has 1 gram of fiber and 120 calories, so 12 grains, but, you know, essentially none of them are whole grains.
That's terrible. It feels like you do need an MD to go shopping.
Which got us thinking, how much whole grain goodness would the average shopper find in their grocery cart? We put 3 smart suburban New York professionals to the test.
Your assignment today.
We gave them a 2020 shopping list with a variety of food categories, like bread, beverages, and crackers. With only 10 minutes to gather the items, we asked them to shop for health in a hurry. While none of our shoppers knew the subject of our story, all 3 came back with plenty of products advertising whole grains. Checking over the carts, Dr. Katz gives his critique.
And we've got Nutri-Grain cereal bars. Now that certainly sounds, just the name alone, sounds like that's something that should be pretty good for you. Interestingly, in 140 calories, there's less than a gram of fiber in this.
Okay.
And that tells us that whatever grain is in here can't be too much whole grain. That's exactly right. Oatmeal bread made with whole grain oats. I bet you thought this sounds like...
Yeah, I thought it sounded good. It was the right color for my daughter.
It looks kind of brown, right?
But Dr. Katz says don't be fooled by brown-colored bread. It's not always an indication of whole grains.
Unbleached, enriched wheat flour. Is that good?
No.
It's not whole wheat flour.
In the cereal category, several shoppers picked General Mills products.
Now, the interesting thing about this box of Kix is it says whole grain right on the front. Yes.
Last year, General Mills became the first leading food manufacturer to emblazon all of their cereals with the whole grain banner. Not just healthy ones like Cheerios and Wheaties, but also Cocoa Puffs and Lucky Charms. Cereals with more sugar than whole grains. Those, according to nutritionists, are basically junk food being passed off as health food.
We responsibly added the whole grain to our cereals at a minimum of 1/2 a serving.
Nutritionist Susan Crockett is the director of the Bell Institute at General Mills.
In a case in America where people are not getting enough, I feel good about what General Mills did.
In fact, many of the dozen top nutritionists we consulted for this story applaud the campaign, calling it a step in the right direction. But some of those same experts also say the nutritional benefits of whole grains in cereals like Trix is undercut by a load of sugar. Some say it's a marketing ploy.
We feel that we advertised and communicated with consumers in a clear, responsible, and non-misleading way. We stepped up to this project with total integrity.
I agree with you that the campaign has a lot of integrity in it, but I question the integrity of this huge sign that implies that this is healthy when every nutritionist that we talked to said this is not healthy.
We feel fine about the banner of whole grain on our pre-sweetened cereals. It is truthful and non-misleading.
It's not misleading. You don't think this is misleading?
That cereal contains half a serving, defined by the government, a very high bar.
This is candy, basically. And yeah, there's a little bit of whole grain in here, but there's a lot of whole grain lettering on the front of the package.
So how can General Mills get away with marketing whole grains in a sugar cereal the same way they do in a healthy cereal? The new FDA guidelines only suggest that food manufacturers tell you how much whole grains you're getting. Until these recommendations are approved, cutting through the confusion takes a lot of work.
So when you look at this label, you don't know what it means.
So according to Dr. Katz, here's the real deal for finding whole grains. Look for the word whole in the first spot on the ingredient list.
The ingredients on a food are listed in order of abundance. You've got to see whole grain because, you know, the difference between wheat flour and whole wheat flour is like the difference between an airplane with and without wings. You know, I mean, a whole airplane's a whole lot better.
And remember, check out the amount of fiber on the facts panel.
If you don't see 2 or more grams of fiber per 100 calories, whatever it says on the front about whole grain, you can forget about it. It's just a token.
In the end, no matter what you're buying, you should check the fine print. It's still the best place to find the whole grain truth.
Go to a place that sells coffee and plenty of people will tell you brown sugar is better.
It's much healthier. Brown sugar is much, much healthier.
Brown sugar seems more natural.
Natural is such a good selling point.
See how like this package has like palm trees on it?
And this package just says,
and it says, and it says natural brown sugar.
And it seems even better if it's raw.
When I see in the raw, I assume it's less processed than white sugar. The same thing with rice.
Good point. Brown rice is less processed and better for you.
Brown rice is healthier than white rice.
Kathy Nonis is a dietitian at New York's North General Hospital.
Brown rice has the whole grain, including the germ and the hull, and so it's very high in fiber.
Brown rice also has significantly more minerals than white rice. But is that true for brown sugar, too? No.
People who are grabbing that brown sugar because they think it's healthier are basically deluding themselves.
Sugar begins as sap in these sugarcane plants, which are crushed or release what they call sugar juice. The juice is heated, which creates a thick, dark molasses containing sugar crystals. They spin that, so centrifugal force removes the molasses, most of which becomes cattle feed. What's left is white granulated sugar. Brown sugar has some of the molasses added back in, and some people say that makes it better.
It is healthy. Brown sugar is much healthier than white sugar.
It is true that molasses tastes a little sweeter, and it contains a little iron and calcium, but very little.
To get the same amount of iron that I could get from just one slice of whole wheat bread, I would have to eat 9 teaspoons of brown sugar.
Brown sugar is not any better than white sugar. People should still reduce their intake of all sugars because they're basically empty calories.
And what about this raw sugar?
I prefer the raw sugar myself. I find it's a much sweeter and more natural taste.
People are very susceptible to marketing. And just because something is natural doesn't mean it's particularly healthy for you.
And raw sugar isn't really raw. It's just slightly less refined. That does mean they leave some of the molasses in. Isn't that better?
There's no more nutritional value in raw sugar than there is in white sugar or brown sugar.
If you ask a pastry chef like Dennis Canciello, he'll tell you the same thing.
Brown sugar being better? No. It's just the taste, just the look. It's sugar. That's all it is. Sugar is sugar.
And there's another myth about sugar. We hear this one from parents all the time. Sugar drives the kids crazy.
Get it!
Even some of the kids believe it.
I go really nuts when they have candy.
And it doesn't matter how old you are.
You get really,
I think so,
hyper. I'm like, oh, I'm on such a sugar rush right now. And like sometimes I'm like, oh my God, I'll clean my room.
You can have like one candy bar and be off the wall.
Lots of people accept the idea that too much sugar makes kids wild or hyper. But is it true?
I keep hearing sugar causes the kids to act up.
The research is very clear. Sugar does not make a child hyperactive.
Many studies have found that. This one, for example, in the New England Journal of Medicine, gave some kids sugared foods and others foods with artificial sweeteners. Their parents and the researchers didn't know who was eating sugar and who wasn't. They monitored the kids for things like irritability and hyperactivity. They found no difference.
There is no such thing as a sugar high, and there is no such thing as sugar making you nuts. There just isn't.
How's the cake? Is it good?
Yeah.
But I've seen kids go crazy at parties. Isn't that because the sugar kicks in?
It's now kicked in. It's now definitely kicked in.
Actually, no. And some of their moms have figured out what's going on.
The kids are hyper. They're hyper because they're excited, because they have freedom, because there's 20 kids crowding around each other.
Right, because it's a party. The studies also say that if food has an effect, it could be the caffeine and chocolate and soda that gives you the buzz. But it's not the sugar.